Dear students, in this video we'll discuss about class 8, Oxford New Learners Grammar and Composition, chapter number 18, Phrases and Clauses. Okay, so if you have not watched the previous chapters, so here look at the screen, you can go to the playlist section and also watch. Okay, so you know phrase is made of a group of words which convey some meaning but don't make complete sense by itself. So here an example. My elder sister is a famous doctor. So this is, you know, it makes a complete sense. Okay, because you know there is a subject, you know, my elder sister, and there is also verb, and also you know here the predicate part is a famous doctor. That means here it makes a complete sense. Okay, but here you know my elder sister, you know my is, you know, possessive adjective here. Okay, possessive. तो यू नो पॉजिटिव मीन्स पॉजिटिव प्रोनाउन पॉजिटिव एडजेक्टिव. ओके माई नेम इज, ओके माई नेम इज रोहन. तो यू नो हियर माई इज पॉजिटिव एडजेक्टिव. ओके दिस इज माई बुक, दिस इज माई बुक. तो यू नो हियर माई इज पॉजिटिव एडजेक्टिव. ओके तो हियर माई एल्डर सिस्टर इज ए फेमस डॉक्टर. तो यू नो हियर माई एल्डर सिस्टर दिस इज ए फ्रेज. यू नो फ्रेज मीन्स ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स दैट डोंट मेक ए कम्प्लीट सेंस. एंड यू नो हियर माई इज पॉजिटिव एडजेक्टिव. एंड यू नो हियर एल्डर इज ऑल्सो एडजेक्टिव. एंड यू नो सिस्टर इज नाउन. दैट मीन्स वी कैन से दैट ए नाउन फ्रेज इज ए कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स बट दे डोंट मेक ए कम्प्लीट सेंस. तो दिस इज वन टाइप ऑफ फ्रेज. ओके सिमिलरली हियर ए फेमस डॉक्टर. तो यू नो हियर ए इज इनडेफिनाइट आर्टिकल. ओके तो हियर ए इज इनडेफिनाइट आर्टिकल. ओके एंड यू नो फेमस इज एन एडजेक्टिव. एंड यू नो डॉक्टर इज ए कॉमन नाउन. तो इट डजंट मेक ए कम्प्लीट सेंस. लाइक माई एल्डर सिस्टर व्हाट, सिमिलरली ए फेमस डॉक्टर. तो इट डजंट मेक ए कम्प्लीट सेंस. तो दिस इज नोन एज यू नो फ्रेज. ओके एंड यू नो इट डजंट हैव ऑल्सो ए सब्जेक्ट माई एल्डर सिस्टर. एंड ऑल्सो डजंट हैव ए वर्ब हियर माई इन माई एल्डर सिस्टर. यू नो देर इज नो सब्जेक्ट एंड यू नो देर इज ऑल्सो नो वर्ब. सो इट डजंट मेक ए कम्प्लीट सेंस. क्लियर. सो दिस इज यू नो फ्रेज. तो हियर ओके माई यू नो पॉजिटिव एडजेक्टिव, यू नो एल्डर यू नो एडजेक्टिव, सिस्टर यू नो कॉमन नाउन. सिमिलरली ए फेमस डॉक्टर यू नो ए इज इंडेफिनेट आर्टिकल, फेमस यू नो एडजेक्टिव, डॉक्टर यू नो कॉमन नाउन. सिमिलरली टेक एन अनदर एग्जांपल इन द गार्डन. ओके तो दिस इज ऑल्सो फ्रेज. यू नो इन इज प्रीपोजिशन. ओके द यू नो आर्टिकल एंड गार्डन यू नो दिस इज नाउन. ओके दिस इज यू नो प्रीपोजिशनल फ्रेज. वी विल रीड मोर अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ फ्रेजेस. ओके तो हियर लेट्स प्रैक्टिस आइडेंटिफाई द फ्रेजेस फ्रॉम द फॉलोइंग लिस्ट. तो यू नो ही इज माई बेस्ट फ्रेंड. तो इट मेक्स ए कम्प्लीट सेंस बिकॉज यू नो हियर द सब्जेक्ट इज ही एंड द वर्ब इज यू नो इज. ओके एंड प्रेडिकेट पार्ट ऑल्सो यू नो इज माई बेस्ट फ्रेंड. दैट मीन्स हियर इट मेक्स ए कम्प्लीट सेंस. सो यू विल कॉल इट इज ए क्लॉज. तो विल रीड मोर अबाउट ओके क्लॉज एंड ऑल्सो टाइप्स ऑफ क्लॉजेस. ओके तो हियर ऑली इज वेरी फॉन्ड ऑफ मी. तो यू नो हियर हियर द सब्जेक्ट इज ऑली एंड वर्ब यू नो इज एंड प्रेडिकेट पार्ट यू नो इज वेरी फॉन्ड ऑफ मी. दैट मीन्स हियर इट मेक्स ए कम्प्लीट सेंटेंस कम्प्लीट सेंस. तो दिस इज नॉट ए फ्रेज दिस इज क्लॉज. ओके तो यू हैव टू जस्ट यू हैव टू फॉलो द इंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द क्वेश्चन आइडेंटिफाई द फ्रेजेस. ओके तो दीज आर नॉट फ्रेजेस. Then next, 15 soldiers of the Indian Air Force. So you know this is a phrase. You know there is no subject, there is no verb. It doesn't make a complete sense. It is a group of words, but it doesn't make a complete sense. So this is a phrase. You have to write phrase here. Okay. Then next here, her mother cooks very well. You know there is subject, her mother, and you know here. Your verb cooks and you know predicate part cooks very well. So this is a clause. This is not a phrase. Okay. The next year has been waiting. You know this is you know phrase. Okay, has been waiting. The next A sumptuous meal. You know here meal is noun, a is indefinite article, and sumptuous, you know this is adjective. So you know this is a phrase, not a clause. Okay. It doesn't make a complete sense. A beautiful girl. Okay. Similarly, a beautiful country. So it doesn't make a complete sense. So it will be called as phrase, not a sentence. Okay. A bunch of yellow flowers. This is also phrase. Clear? There is no subject, no verb to this home. So you know this is also phrase. Clear? So here next, let's learn types of phrases. You know phrases are made by combining different types of words into a group. There is always a particular word around which a group of words or a phrase is formed. The word that plays a central role in a phrase, it is called a main word, or we can call the head of a phrase. What a type of phrase it is depends on this word. Okay, so here look at this example. The first two books in this list are very good. You know here the is, okay, article, definite article, and you know first ordinal. You know ordinal, cardinal, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, this is, you know, cardinal. First, second, third, fourth, you know, this is ordinal. Here, 2, you know, cardinal. The first two books, that means here, the first two, it gives more information about the book. You know, these words, the first two, add extra meaning with the noun, you know, head word, books. In this list, you know, in is, you know, preposition. Okay, this, that, these, those, you know, these are known as demonstrative. You know, list is your noun. Okay, so here, you know, here head word is noun, and the words that are used before the head word, you know, these are known as pre-modifier. Okay, pre-modifier. So here, take another example. A brave boy. Okay, do you know head word? Here head word means head noun. We are talking about the boy, and you know here a is article, indefinite article, brave is an adjective. So here a brave will be called as pre-modifiers. Okay, you know pre-modifiers are used before noun to modify the noun. Clear? So similarly here, okay, so here noun, that means you know the first two, that are, you know, these words are known as pre-modifier. Okay, then you know in this list you know these are post-modifier. You know the word that are used after the head word. You know here the head word, you know, noun, and the words, you know, preposition, here in, demonstrative, adjective, you know, this list, these are, you know, post-modifier. Okay, that are used after the head word. Head word, you know, here noun, books. Okay, are very good, you know, are, you know, verb, and very, you know, adverb of degree. Okay, intensifier, you know, adverb. The, you know, he is too weak, you know, too is adverb of degree. I have got completely wet in the rain. The, you know, completely means adverb of degree. Clear? So here very, you know, intensifier, that means here adverb of degree. Okay, and good, you know, adjective. The, you know, intensify, that means very good. This is, you know, adjective phrase, that means it add also extra meaning about the books. Okay, books, the first two books in this list are very good. Clear? So here, you know, this is noun phrase. Okay, the first books, the first two books in this list, you know, this is noun phrase. Okay, so here in the first phrase, the first two books in the list, okay, common noun books gives you the main information, that is when you read the phrase, you know that someone is talking, yes, someone is talking about the head word noun, that means your books. So similarly, the words here, the first, similar the words, the first two in this list give you additional information about the common noun. So these words, you know, help you specify the book that the speaker is referring to. So this is, you know, noun phrase. Okay, तो हियर सिंस बुक्स प्लेज ए सेंट्रल रोल इन दिस पैसेज इन दिस फ्रेज तो इट इज द मेन वर्ड आज द मेन वर्ड ऑफ द एबव फ्रेज इट इज एन एबव फ्रेज इज ए नाउन तो इट इज कॉल्ड ए नाउन फ्रेज ओके वी यूज प्री मोडिफायर टू मोडिफाई द नाउन एंड वी ऑल्सो यूज पोस्ट मोडिफायर टू मोडिफाई द नाउन तो वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द मेन वर्ड और यू नो हेड वर्ड ऑफ द सेंटेंस तो यू नो हेड वर्ड इज बुक्स ओके तो दिस इज यू नो हियर द फर्स्ट टू बुक्स इन दिस लिस्ट यू नो दिस इज नाउन फ्रेज एंड यू नो हियर वेरी गुड दिस इज एडजेक्टिव फ्रेज ओके तो यू नो देर आर फाइव टाइप्स ऑफ फ्रेजेस यू नो फर्स्ट वन इज नाउन फ्रेज ओके तो यू नो ए नाउन फ्रेज इज वन इन व्हिच द मेन वर्ड इज ए नाउन ओके ए नाउन फ्रेज प्लेज ए रोल सिमिलर टू दैट ऑफ ए नाउन इन ए सेंटेंस तो हियर लुक एट दिस एग्जाम्पल माई एल्डर सिस्टर इज वेरी स्मार्ट यू नो हियर इज वेरी स्मार्ट एंड माई एल्डर सिस्टर यू नो हियर माई आज यू नो माई इज एडजेक्टिव पॉजिटिव एडजेक्टिव एंड एल्डर यू नो एडजेक्टिव एंड यू नो हियर सिस्टर दैट मीन्स हियर इन माई एल्डर सिस्टर सिस्टर इज द हेड वर्ड एंड माई यू नो माई एल्डर दैट आर्ट्स एक्स्ट्रा मीनिंग अबाउट सिस्टर यू नो हियर माई एल्डर सिस्टर यू नो दिस इज नाउन फ्रेज ओके यू नो दिस आर हियर माई एल्डर दिस इज यू नो प्री मोडिफायर ओके प्री मोडिफायर एंड यू नो वेरी स्मार्ट इज वेरी स्मार्ट यू नो दिस इज यू नो पोस्ट मोडिफायर तो यू नो वेरी एडवर्ब डिग्री स्मार्ट इज एडजेक्टिव तो दिस इज पोस्ट मोडिफायर दिज आर पोस्ट मोडिफायर एंड माई एल्डर यू नो दिज आर प्री मोडिफायर क्लियर ओके तो लेट्स टेक सम मोर अदर एग्जाम्पल्स तो हियर यू नो ए स्टूडेंट ओके ए स्टूडेंट तो यू नो दिस इज ए नाउन फ्रेज एंड यू नो हियर द मेन वर्ड हेड वर्ड यू नो स्टूडेंट एंड यू नो ए इज आर्टिकल प्री मोडिफायर ओके तो सिमिलर टेक एन अनदर एग्जाम्पल फ्यू गुड स्टूडेंट ओके फ्यू गुड स्टूडेंट स्टूडेंट्स तो यू नो हियर स्टूडेंट्स दिस इज द मेन वर्ड और यू नो हेड वर्ड ओके हेड वर्ड एंड यू नो गुड फ्यू यू नो दिस इज नोन एज प्री मोडिफायर तो दिस इज ए नाउन फ्रेज ओके फ्यू गुड स्टूडेंट्स यू नो दिस इज नोन एज नाउन फ्रेज क्लियर तो सिमिलरली टेक अदर एग्जाम्पल्स सिमिलरली दोज राइप पियर्स ओके तो यू नो हियर पियर्स इज ए हेड वर्ड ओके एंड यू नो हियर दोज राइप दिस इज यू नो प्री मोडिफायर एंड यू नो दिस इज दीज राइप पियर्स यू नो दिस इज नाउन फ्रेज क्लियर देन नेक्स्ट ईयर एडजेक्टिव फ्रेज ओके यू नो एन एडजेक्टिव फ्रेज इज वन इन व्हिच द मेन वर्ड इज एन एडजेक्टिव तो सिमिलरली यू नो इन नाउन फ्रेज नाउन इज द मेन यू नो नाउन इज द हेड वर्ड सिमिलरली इन एन एडजेक्टिव फ्रेज एन एडजेक्टिव इज द मेन वर्ड ओके इन द फ्रेज तो हियर माई एल्डर सिस्टर इज वेरी स्मार्ट यू नो हियर माई एल्डर सिस्टर यू नो दिस इज नाउन फ्रेज ओके एंड यू नो वेरी स्मार्ट दिस इज यू नो एडजेक्टिव फ्रेज ओके दैट मीन्स हियर वेरी स्मार्ट टेल्स और एड्स एक्स्ट्रा इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट माई एल्डर सिस्टर एंड यू नो हियर स्मार्ट इज एडजेक्टिव एंड यू नो वेरी इज एडवर्ब डिग्री और वी कॉल इंटेंसिफायर ओके एडवर्ब डिग्री तो यू नो तो हियर द हेड वर्ड इज एडजेक्टिव दैट मीन्स हियर द हेड वर्ड इज स्मार्ट एडजेक्टिव वेरी स्मार्ट हु इज वेरी स्मार्ट माई एल्डर सिस्टर इज वेरी स्मार्ट यू नो वेरी स्मार्ट दिस इज यू नो एडजेक्टिव फ्रेज यू नो फ्रेज मीन्स ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स तो हियर वेरी स्मार्ट ओके वेरी स्मार्ट विल बी कॉल्ड एज एडजेक्टिव फ्रेज क्लियर तो सिमिलरली टेक अनदर एग्जाम्पल द करी वॉज वेरी डेलीशियस ओके द करी वॉज वेरी ओके डेलीशियस तो यू नो हियर द करी वाच वेरी डेलीशियस तो यू नो हियर वेरी डेलीशियस दिस इज यू नो आर्जेटिव फ्रेज यू नो हियर वेरी इज एडवर्ब ऑफ डिग्री इंटेंसिफायर एंड यू नो हियर डेलीशियस इज आर्जेटिव यू नो वेरी हियर मोडिफाइज द आर्जेटिव डेलीशियस एंड यू नो हियर वेरी डेलीशियस टेल्स मोर अबाउट द करी हाउ वाज द करी द करी वाज वेरी डेलीशियस यू नो हियर द आर्जेटिव इज डेलीशियस एंड यू नो हियर द आर्जेटिव फ्रेज वेरी डेलीशियस ओके यू नो हियर आर्जेटिव इज द हेड वर्ड ओके तो वेरी डेलीशियस विल बी कॉल्ड एज आर्जेटिव फ्रेज क्लियर देन टेक एन अनदर एग्जाम्पल द मूवी वाज रियली एक्सीलेंट ओके द मूवी वाज really excellent really excellent you know really means you know adverb of degree okay and you know excellent is an adjective so here excellent is the adjective that is the main head word okay and it tells more about the how the movie was that means the movie was really excellent that means you know here really excellent this is known as adjective phrase really excellent clear then next here the here you know modifiers are words that give additional information about or describe the main words in a phrase right the you know here modifiers are we can say very you know here very adds extra information about smart okay then next here when to here when an adjective is placed before a noun to you know this is known as noun phrase when an adjective is placed before a noun that means you know my elder sister here adjective is my and also elder and noun you know sister this is you know here it simply plays the role of a modifier and not that of a main word okay So since there are no nouns in an adjective phrase, the adjective plays the main role of the word. That means very smart. You know here very smart adjective phrase. Clear? Then next here, a verb phrase. Okay. So you know similarly, as in noun phrase, noun is the head word. Similarly in adjective phrase, adjective is the head word. So here in verb phrase, verb will be the main head word. Okay. So here. ओके भर फ्रेज तो यू नो भर फ्रेजेस इन इंग्लिश हैव द फॉलोइंग फॉर्म्स तो यू कैन रिप्रेजेंट द भर फ्रेज इन दिस वेज तो यू नो वी आर स्टूडेंट्स तो यू नो हियर आर यू नो वी कॉल इट इज अ मेन भर्ब ओके एंड यू नो हियर देयर इज ओनली वन भर्ब आर सिमिलरली इन द नेक्स्ट सेंटेंस आई नो हिम तो हियर नो इज अ भर्ब मेन भर्ब एवरीबॉडी लव्स मी तो यू नो लव्स इज द मेन भर्ब ही प्लेड तो हियर प्लेड इज द मेन भर्ब दैट मीन्स We can say here R is also a verb phrase, no is also a verb phrase, loves is also a verb phrase, played is also a verb phrase. But as you have read the definition of phrase means it is a group of words. But here the verb tells about what the subject does. Okay, so here a verb phrase which only a main verb is expressing the simple aspect. Okay. Then next here you know auxiliary verb and a main verb is ing that means you know ing means present participle they are playing cricket so you know here are is auxiliary verb and playing is main verb so similarly she was writing was you know helping verb writing you know main verb okay so you know a verb phrase with be and ing expresses the continuous aspect that means you know present continuous or past continuous so here verb phrase will be are playing Here was writing. That means it tells about what the subject is doing in the sentence. Was writing means what is the subject doing? You know, subject is she. She was writing. So here verb phrase will be was writing. The main word. Similarly, they are playing cricket. That means here the verb tells more about the subject. That means what the subject is doing. They are playing. So you know here are playing will be verb phrase. Clear? Similarly, next here have. Auxiliary verb and the past participle. Okay, so you know I have visited Delhi twice. So you know here have is auxiliary verb, visited you know main verb, and you know here have visited it you know tells about what the subject is doing. You know I have visited what the subject is doing or what the subject has done or will do in the future. Okay, have and visited this will be called as you know verb phrase. Okay. Similarly, she has passed the exam. So here has passed will be verb phrase. तो इट इज ए ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स, बट इन द प्रीवियस एग्जाम्पल्स आज यू रीड हियर, ओके, ओनली मेन वर्ब, तो दिस कैन बी कॉल्ड एज यू नो वर्ब फ्रेज, ओके, आर, नो, लव्स, प्लेड, यू नो सिंपल एस्पेक्ट, क्लियर। सिमिलरली हियर ए वर्ब फ्रेज विथ हैव एंड पास्ट पार्टिसिपल एक्सप्रेसेस द प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट, यस, हैज और हैव, एंड द पास्ट पार्टिसिपल, पास्ट पार्टिसिपल यू नो थर्ड फॉर्म ऑफ द वर्ब V3 एक्सप्रेसेस द प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट, यस, तो हैव इन द प्रेजेंट विथ ए पास्ट पार्टिसिपल इज द प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट, यस, तो हैड विथ ए पास्ट पार्टिसिपल इज द पास्ट परफेक्ट, यू नो हैड प्लस V3 दिस इज पास्ट परफेक्ट एंड विल बी, दिस विल बी नोन एज वर्ब फ्रेज, तो हियर हैज और हैव, हियर हैज और हैव प्लस V3 दिस इज यू नो प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट, ओके। The next is have auxiliary and past participle been with the main verb in ing. In ing for that means present perfect continuous or past perfect continuous. So here it has been raining since morning. So you know here has been raining. This is verb phrase. Okay. You know this is auxiliary verb and been you know past participle been has been used here and raining in progressive. That means it indicates. The action was started in the past, it is now continuing, okay, and it will end in the future, okay. So, you know, this is known as a verb phrase. So, here group of words has, been, raining, okay. So, here a verb phrase with have and participle been with the main verb ing, it is, you know, present perfect continuous. Similarly, verb with had plus been प्लस V1 ing इट विल बी पास्ट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूस, ओके। तो हियर ए मोडल वर्ब एंड ए मेन वर्ब, राइट, तो हियर यू नो ए मोडल वर्ब्स कैन कुड विल वुड शैल शुड मे माइट मस्ट यू नो डेयर और टू दीज आर नोन एज यू नो ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब, मोडल ऑक्सिलरी, दे विल विजिट द स्कूल टुमारो, यू नो दे विल विजिट, यू नो हियर विल विजिट दिस इज नोन एज वर्ब फ्रेज, ओके। तो सिमिलरली हियर मे आई कम इन तो यू नो हियर द वर्ब फ्रेज इज मे एंड कम, दिस इज वर्ब फ्रेज, ओके। वी कैन यूज मोडल वर्ब्स विथ ऑक्सिलरीज, राइट, ओके। दे विल बी विजिटिंग, तो हियर यू नो विल बी विजिटिंग दिस इज वर्ब फ्रेज। सिमिलरली ही माइट हैव पास्ट द एग्जाम, माइट हैव पास्ट, तो यू नो दिस इज वर्ब फ्रेज, क्लियर। तो हियर जस्ट ए सिंपल एग्जाम्पल हियर दैट विल मेक यू मोर क्लियर अबाउट वर्ब फ्रेज। श्रेया इज राइटिंग ए लेटर, तो दिस सेंटेंस यू नो यूजेस टू वर्ब्स, इज एंड ऑल्सो राइटिंग, राइटिंग यू नो मेन वर्ब, ओके। तो इज यू नो इट इज एन ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब दैट इज ए हेल्पिंग वर्ब, ओके, दैट हेल्प्स द मेन वर्ब और प्रोवाइड मोर इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट व्हेन द एक्शन अकर्ड। टुगेदर द वर्ब फ्रेज यू नो इज राइटिंग टेल्स द रीडर्स दैट द एक्शन इज हैपनिंग राइट नाउ, यू नो, ओके। तो राइटिंग ए लेटर यू नो दिस इज वर्ब फ्रेज इज राइटिंग, क्लियर। तो आई थिंक यू हैव गॉट ए कंप्लीट आइडिया अबाउट वर्ब फ्रेज, ओके। देन नेक्स्ट कम टू तो हियर यू नो इन दिस, तो हियर सी हैज बीन वर्किंग ऑल डे, इन द फ्रेज हैज बीन वर्किंग द मेन वर्ड इज द प्रेजेंट पार्टिसिपल फॉर्म ऑफ द वर्ब वर्क दैट इज वर्किंग एंड द ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब्स हैज एंड बीन हेल्प द मेन वर्ब टू कन्वे द टाइम ऑफ द एक्शन एक्सप्रेस्ड, क्लियर। देन नेक्स्ट यू नो ए प्रीपोजिशनल फ्रेज इज वन इन व्हिच द मेन वर्ड इज ए प्रीपोजिशन, यस। तो हियर लुक एट दिस एग्जाम्पल, सी हैज बीन वर्किंग ऑल डे ऑन हर प्रोजेक्ट, ओके। तो यू नो प्रीपोजिशंस यूजुअली रिक्वायर एन ऑब्जेक्ट टू कंप्लीट देयर मीनिंग, तो देयरफॉर इट कैन बी सेड दैट द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ ए प्रीपोजिशन हर प्रोजेक्ट, दैट मीन्स सी हैज बीन वर्किंग ऑल डे ऑन व्हाट ऑन हर प्रोजेक्ट, तो यू नो हर प्रोजेक्ट दिस इज यू नो ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ द प्रीपोजिशन, ओके। तो सेड दैट द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ द प्रीपोजिशन कैन नॉट बी द मेन वर्ड, व्हेन ए प्रीपोजिशन इज एट द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द फ्रेज तो इट इज द मेन वर्ड दैट मीन्स ऑन, इट यू नो इट इज द ऑन इज यू नो मेन वर्ड दैट इज प्रीपोजिशन, तो दिस विल बी कॉल्ड एज ए प्रीपोजिशनल फ्रेज, ओके, दैट मीन्स ऑन हर प्रोजेक्ट, दिस इज द ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स, दिस इज फ्रेज, ओके। तो सिमिलरली टेक एन अनदर एग्जाम्पल, ही इज हाइडिंग अंडर द टेबल, ओके, He is hiding under the table. Do you know here? Under is a preposition. That means he is hiding where? Under what? Under the table. So this is the object of the preposition. So here, under modifies the verb hiding. He is hiding where? He is hiding under the table. Do you know? Under the table, this is known as a prepositional phrase. Clear? Similarly, take another example. They are laughing at him. Okay? They are laughing at him. They are laughing at him. So you know here, preposition is used at. They are laughing at. They are laughing at him. So you know here, him is object of the preposition. And at is the here object of the preposition of, you know, at. Okay, and at him, you know, this is a prepositional phrase. Clear? So similarly, take another example. The girl in the blue dress is my sister. Okay, the girl in the blue dress is my sister. Okay, so you know here the girl is my sister. Okay, in the blue dress, you know, in the blue dress, this is, you know, prepositional phrase, in the blue dress. Okay, so here in the blue dress will be called as a prepositional phrase. Similarly, take another example. He lives across the street. He lives across the street. So you know here, he lives where? Across the street. So you know here, across is a preposition and across where? You know, across the street. So you know here, across the street will be called as a prepositional phrase. Okay, prepositional phrase. Clear? So you know here, the head word is across. It tells about where he lives. Okay? Then take another example. He is standing in front of the gate. He is standing in front of the gate. Okay? So you know here the preposition is used in front of, and you know it tells about where he is standing. So here the head word is in front of, okay, and the gate, in front of the gate, this is, you know, prepositional phrase. It tells us where the subject is, okay, where the subject is standing. That means where he is standing, clear? So here in front of the gate will be called as prepositional phrase, clear? Then take another example. The monkey is on the tree. The monkey is on the tree. So you know here, on is the preposition. You know, on here is preposition. That means it tells us where the monkey is. On the tree. So you know, on the tree, this is, you know, prepositional phrase. Clear? And you know here the head word is on, preposition. And you know, on the tree will be called as a prepositional phrase. Clear? The next year, you know, adverbial phrase. So you know, an adverbial phrase is one in which the main word is an adverb. Okay, so here, she has been working on her project, okay, very sincerely. You know, there are two adverbs used. You know, very, adverb of degree. Okay, and sincerely, you know, adverb of manner. Okay, that means, you know, in the phrase very sincerely, the head word is the adverb sincerely, which gives information about how the work is being done very sincerely. Okay, so here the adverb sincerely modifies the verb working. Okay, here working. So here the word very in turn modifies the main word. That means how has he been working? She has been working very sincerely. Okay, here the main word, you know, sincerely, the adverb. Okay, clear? here look at the screen, these are the examples of adverbial phrase. Okay, clear? Then next, identify the types of underline phrases. Okay, so here I went to buy some medicine, you know medicine is noun and some, you know here quantifier, quantity, you know adjective. Okay, so this is a noun phrase, clear? But it was not available at any store, you know here at is a preposition. Okay, so here this phrase will be called as a prepositional phrase. Okay, then next, I find this book extremely useful. Do you know I find this book extremely useful? Do you know this book, this you know here demonstrative and book you know noun. So here this will be noun phrase. This book, okay, extremely useful. Do you know here useful is an adjective. Okay, and extremely you know adverb. Okay, so this will be called as adverbial phrase. Do you have tried here? Okay, you know the first one noun phrase and extremely useful, this is you know adverbial phrase. Okay, then next, Biman left the office very sadly. You know very is an adverb, sadly is also adverb, that means here you know this is adverbial phrase. Okay, it tells about how did he leave the office. Okay, Gita has already booked her holiday. Do you know here this is verb phrase, has already booked, this is you know present perfect. Okay, this is verb phrase. Then next, George was so angry that he left the room. You know so is you know adverb of degree and angry you know adjective, that means it is adjective phrase. Okay, so here five number you know adjective phrase. Then next, those children were playing in the field happily. You know in the field, in you know preposition. Okay, so here it tells about where the children are playing, that means here in the field will be called as prepositional phrase. Okay, the next year, please leave the book on the table. So you know here on is a preposition, that is this is the head word, and where on the table, so you know this is a prepositional phrase. Okay, seven number you know prepositional phrase. Then next, Jyotika has been working here for quite some time. So you know has been working, this is a verb phrase. Okay, then next, my sister remains awake till quite late. You know here quite right adverb of degree, late is also adverb, you know this is adverbial phrase. Okay, then next, I love these beautiful green apples from my neighbor's orchard. You know here the main head word, you know apples. Okay, noun, you know here the words that are used before, you know these, you know demonstrative, beautiful adjective, green adjective, you know these are known as pre modifier. Okay, from my neighbor's orchard, you know this is post modifier, so you know this is noun phrase. Okay, then next, you know clause. You know a clause is a group of words that must have a subject and a predicate and at least one verb to communicate an idea or a thought. Do you know here wait until the evening? Do you know here wait is the main verb? Okay, and until the evening, you know this is a prepositional phrase. Until, you know preposition is the head word. Okay, here there is a main verb, that means you know a clause is a group of words, it must have a subject and a predicate. So you know in imperative sentence the subject is hidden. Okay, so you know here the subject is you, and you know have a subject and a predicate, and a predicate you know here all the part wait until the morning, so you know this is a clause. Okay, then next, you must wait until the evening. So you know here you know subject is pronoun you, must wait till the evening, you know here must wait, this is you know verb phrase. Okay, until the evening, this is you know prepositional phrase, and it combines, it is a you know clause. Here subject is you and predicate you know must wait until the evening, clear? So here notice that in the sentence, in the sentences above, there is a verb and either an explicit subject as in the sentence 2 or an implicit subject as in sentence 1. Okay, so therefore both the sentences are clauses, because you know here the hidden subject is you and predicate part wait until the evening, and you know here the subject is you and predicate you know must wait until the evening. This will be, so these both are will be clauses. Clear? So here look at this table. This is the div. There is some differences between you know phrases and also clauses. Don't have a you know in phrases. Don't have a subject or predicate. Yes, in the garden. So this is a phrase. You know, there is no subject, no predicate. This is the first point. You know, don't have a subject or a predicate. So you know here next, don't have a verb or expect in a verb phrase. Yes. So there, you know, don't have a verb, but in a verb phrase there is a verb, but it is. So don't have a verb, except in a verb phrase. Okay. So like take an example. You must try to reach there. Okay. So you know here must try. So this is a verb phrase. You know this is a verb phrase. It doesn't make a complete sense. Okay. Then next, cannot stand by themselves. Yes, so it requires, you know, here must try, requires other group of words to make it a complete sentence. Similarly, you know, in the garden. So here it requires other words to make it complete sense. You know, he plays in the garden. So here it makes a complete sentence, complete sense. You know, here it when we add some group of words, so it makes a complete sense. So you know it cannot stand by themselves. That means it doesn't make a complete sense itself. Don't make a complete sense, right? Then next year clauses have a subject and a predicate. Yes, so you know in clauses there is subject and also predicate, like you know me. So you know this is a clause, because you know this is the group of words, and you know here the subject you, and know me, this is predicate. So this is a clause. Must have at least one verb. Yes, right. Do you know this is, there is at least a verb in clause. You know here no is verb, main verb. Some clauses can stand alone by themselves. They are called independent clauses. So you will read, there are two types of clauses: dependent clauses and independent clauses. Independent clauses, you know, known as principal clauses, and dependent clause, you know, subordinate clause. Okay. The independent clauses make a complete sense. So you know this is independent clause, or we call it is a principal clause. You know me. It doesn't depend upon other words to make it complete sense, because it itself make a complete sense. So this is known as a principal clause. Clear? So here identify the following as phrase or clauses. So you know the White House. So you know here E.g. pre-modifier, indefinite article, White House, it does not make a complete sense. So you have to write phrase P. Okay. She visited the White House. So this is a clause, because you know there is subject C and a predicate C, visited the White House. So this is a clause. Which clause? You know, this is principal clause, or this is independent clause. Riddhi loves grammar. You know, your subject is Riddhi and loves grammar, this is predicate. So this is a clause. Okay. Which clause? You know, this is independent clause or principal clause. The next here, John's green shirt. You know here, shirt, this is noun, and you know here pre-modifier, possessive. You know John's, you know this is possessive noun, okay? And green, you know adjective. So this is a phrase, not a clause. 20 tired cranes from a far off land. So you know this is also a phrase, group of words. You know it doesn't make a complete sense. Then next, watching migratory birds can be fun. Yes, you know this is a clause. Okay, it makes a complete sense. Then next, you know I am watching a film. Yes, this is also a clause, independent clause. This is also independent clause. Okay. Then next here, please meet my neighbor Jim. Yes, so this is, you know, clause, independent clause. Okay. Then next, those pretty big yellow tulips in my garden. So you know here head word is tulips. Okay. And you know those pretty big yellow, this is a pre-modifier, and in my garden is, this is, you know, prepositional phrase. Okay. You know this is a phrase, not a clause. I want to watch a film in the evening. So this is a clause, independent clause. Okay. Clear?
So if you find any doubt, you can comment in the comment box. In the next video, we will discuss the remaining parts. Okay, thank you.